My name is Dr. Michael Endl. I'm a professor in astronomy and physics at Austin Community College. At this episode of ACC Experts, I'm gonna talk about solar eclipses and explain to you what you can expect when a solar eclipse occurs at that place where you live. Let's do this. A solar eclipse is actually something very, very simple. What happens is, and this is an awfully incorrect scale model, here's our sun, which is of course way bigger in relation to the Earth and the moon. This is our moon, this is our Earth. But just to demonstrate what is going on, you all know that the moon is orbiting around the Earth. So sometimes the moon orbits right in between our Earth and the sun, and it casts its shadow onto the surface of the Earth, then you experience a solar eclipse. This doesn't happen every month, simply for the reason that the orbit of the Earth around the sun is in one plane, and the orbit of the moon around the Earth is in a slightly different plane. It's a little bit inclined, and that's the reason why we don't have solar and lunar eclipses every month, but much rarer. So there are two types of solar eclipses. They are called partial eclipses and total eclipses. And like the name says, one is total, meaning the moon covers 100% of the surface of the sun. And the other one is called partial because the moon doesn't cover 100%, but maybe just 90% or 99%. And the difference is literally day and night, because just 1% still visible of the surface of the sun is bright enough to basically make it look to you almost like a normal day. While a total eclipse, when the sun is completely covered, then you will see all these spectacular and awe-inspiring things that you enjoy when you see a total solar eclipse. So solar eclipses are actually not that rare. On average, they occur every 18 months. But what is very rare is that you, on any given point on this planet, will be under the shadow of the moon. So when the moon casts its shadow onto the surface of the Earth, it actually only covers a very tiny portion, less than 1% of the surface area of the Earth. So it's really a thing about, you have to be at the right time, at the right place. And since our Earth is just spinning around and moving, that means that a solar eclipse can cover any kind of almost random part of the Earth's surface. For any particular part on our planet, the average duration between solar eclipses is 375 years. If you don't want to move, it is a solar eclipse. It's a very, very rare event, probably a once-in-a-lifetime event for you. We will see a total solar eclipse on April 8th, 2024. And it's gonna be a very, very important event because it will cross through Texas, basically from coming out of Mexico will come the shadow, traveling northeast through central Texas. It's gonna be April 8th, it's a Monday. It's gonna be around 1 p.m. And the duration of totality, meaning when the moon covers completely the sun, is only gonna be around 2 to 4 minutes, depending on where you are. The whole eclipse will unfold over like 2 or 3 hours. That takes much longer, where you see the moon moving in very, very slowly. So the problem is that you don't want to look directly into the sun. Before totality and after totality, you need protective goggles. And what is even more important is that you don't use any optical devices to even increase and magnify the intensity of the sun. Don't use any binoculars, even if it's very tempting. cameras can be difficult. Depends if the light can directly get to your eye. It can really damage your eye, and that's why we have these protective goggles. But another super important thing is that people typically don't know is that at the moment of totality, when the moon really totally covers the sun, you have to take it off, because otherwise you miss the entire show. Those glasses cut down intensity over 99.9%. So you will miss all the spectacular views during totality. Usually what you have is you have somebody keeping an eye actually on the time. And when the totality is about to be over, there will be a little bit of a signal going on that people put on their glasses again. First of all, it gets dark. That you probably expect. But the thing is, it's a weird darkness. It's not like night. It's not gonna get pitch black dark, but it gets very, very close to very dark twilight. And it's dark enough that when you then look up, you see the solar corona. This is the outermost atmosphere of the sun, like a ghostly glow emanating from the moon. And then, of course, you see stars. It's so dark that you see the brightest stars in the sky. And you see the planets. You see very easily Mercury and Venus, which are always close to the sun, in your sky. But the most impressive thing, at least for me, is that you have a 360-degree sunset on your horizon. So when you look then to the horizon and look around, you actually look so far that you can see the end of the edge of the moon's shadow. And at the edge of the moon's shadow, our atmosphere is playing around with the light the same it does when you have a sunset. So you have a kind of almost rainbow colors, but predominantly reddish, orangey ring around you, 360 degrees during totality. It's absolutely beautiful. Because they are so rare at any given point on the planet, typically people can happily go through their lives without having seen one total solar eclipse. Of course, you always have to be lucky with the weather. If it's cloudy, then of course it is not the same experience. But if you're lucky and it's clear, and Texas is a good place for this, you will have this complete unique natural phenomenon that you experience, which is, as I said, it is really, really awe-inspiring, and you will tell your grandkids about this. It's such a unique thing, and it's also such a nice thing because you don't need anything. You know, it's something that nature, the cosmos offers us, and it's a beautiful display of kind of what's going on in space. Thank you so much for watching this episode of ACC Experts about solar eclipses. Once again, my name is Dr. Michael Endl. I teach astronomy and physics at Austin Community College. And if you want to get more involved into our program, visit our website at austincc.edu/astronomy.